Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Katonah Elementary School. My name is Quan Stambaugh, the assistant principal. We're so happy to see our families and friends and district guests here. We're going to get started by rising, and if you would, please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. I'm Christy Harris. I'm the principal here at KES, and I'm very, very excited and honored to be here today to celebrate our very special group of fifth graders. Let's give them a hand for doing such a beautiful job walking in this morning. I wanted to let everyone know that we do have a photographer here who is going to be taking pictures as each individual child is recognized here with their teacher, and then there will also be a class photo over here on the risers. So as much as you want to take your own pictures, which is great, just know that you'll have these to rely on that will be sent out to you at some point, so you'll have those as well, which is great. So without further ado, we're going to get right into it. We're going to individually recognize our students, and we're going to start, we're going to go alphabetical. We're going to start with Mrs. Burns' class, and if Mrs. Burns' class could please stand and make your way to your spot that we've been practicing. She's already crying. Okay? Yeah.
We spent a whole year together, and then all of a sudden they just go. Okay, so we'll start with Sarah Barr. Sophia Beobide. Kate Bechara. Yeah. Asher Burke. Sana Duse. Riley Guadron. Matilda Guariento. Elena Hertzberg. Connor Jukum. Colin Kazanecki. Jacob Lieberman. Carly Martin. Kingsley Niles. Aida Omerovic. Teodora Popescu. Ayanna Price. Jonah Rappaport. Casey Stanford. Lily Sukiel. Hayden Swana. Miles Vaknin. And Alessia Woodard. I present to you Mrs. Burns' fifth grade class of 2023.
First row one. Hang on. Row two. Perfect. Okay, a hard act to follow. They did pretty perfectly. Miss Garofolo's class, if you could please stand. Ms. Garofolo, Ms. Crone's class, please join us.
Good morning. Thirty years ago, I didn't need glasses for this. Eric Asta. Emmett Barrow. Ellie Charles. Annabelle Chiffo. Phoenix Goldstein. Lily Gorenfeld. Ben Gregoire. Isabel Heeman. Eliza Isaacson. Archer Kendall. Gabby Lesmeray. Jaya Lieberman. Shannon McGill. Cora Nelson. Andrew Oliver. Molly Orcutt. Amanda Popescu. Brody Sarahoff. Rosie Teagan. And Emma Williams. I think this was the first time I had to do this without using their nicknames, so it was a little challenging. Miss Crone is with us also this morning, and I proudly present to you Five Garofolo.
So proud of them. They're doing a great job this morning. Ms. Patterson and Ms. Hirsch's class, please stand. Do you think you could slide by them? Yeah, we could try.
We're just going to take a moment here to soak this all in. We told the fifth graders, just take a moment and be present. It's really been a pleasure and a privilege to be with your children this year. So we're going to start with Henry Becker. Emma Burke. Alex Cooney. Bradley D'Alessandro. Colette Delahunte. Gerard Donnelly. Sebastian Goldstein. Issa Gay.
Oh, in the middle. Come in the middle.
Fiona Heavens.
Caroline Jang.
Juliet Johnson.
Lane Krulik.
Jacqueline Mattiello.
Natalie Mazariegos Nahera.
Charlotte Parker.
Allegra Pease.
Monica Popescu.
Sophia Ropa.
Jack Simmons.
Sienna Stingone.
Emily Velishka.
Jordan Vigiano.
Giselle Wetzel.
Tazio Zoli.
We present to you our class of 2023.
The next part of our program is for the children to give some entertainment to the guests this morning. So after Ms. Hirsch's and Ms. Patterson's class have a seat, we're going to make one more transition to the risers. I have full confidence based on their performance so far that they can handle this. Ms. Burns' class, please stand and please go to riser 1, 2, or 3 based on your assignment. Great job. Ms. Garofolo and Ms. Crone's class, please join your friends on the risers, 1, 2, and 3. And Ms. Patterson and Ms. Hirsch's class, Ms. Delaney. Mr. Gelfer is going to lead this portion of our ceremony. Enjoy.
Opportunity. KES, yes, we're feeling fine.
congratulations. You sounded absolutely beautiful this morning. Let's give them a big round of applause. Made all of us cry. Amazing job. Amazing. Okay, riser one, if you could please go back to your seats, please. Okay, riser two, step down and step down again. Riser three, stay where you are. Go ahead, find your seats. And riser three, step down. And again, careful. Good job. All right, fifth graders, your part's over for now. You can sit back and relax. You did your thing. You did it well. You made us all proud. All right, so I have just a few things that I'd like to say to this group of students. I prepared a short speech, not to bore you. Can you all see the screen?
Yes.
Okay, it'll come on in just a second. This is a story that I've used before. I don't usually repeat speeches, but I love this one so much that I put a little extra spin on it today for this special group of students, but I hope you enjoy it. It's meaningful to me as well. Let me give me the thumbs up when you can see the screen. So I've known most of these children since kindergarten. Raise your hand if you've been here since kindergarten. Yep. What beautiful young women and men you've grown into. Okay. So this is the story of a pencil maker. Once upon a time, there was a pencil maker. He made pencils of every shape, color, and design, and took great pride in his pencils. And after making a pencil, and before putting it into the pencil box, he held it up and gave the pencil some advice. There are five things you need to know before I send you into the world. I want you to always remember these five things. Live by them, and you will become a great and mighty pencil. And here are the five pieces of advice he gave each pencil. Number one, everything you do will always leave a mark. Number two, you can always correct the mistakes you make. Number three, what is important is what's inside of you. Number four, in life, you will undergo painful sharpening, which will only make you better. And number five, to be the best pencil, you must always allow yourself to be held and guided by the hands that hold you. The pencil understood, promised to remember, and went into the box with purpose in its heart. Now, fifth graders, just as the pencil maker gave his pencils advice before placing them into a box and shipping them off to classrooms around the world, as your principal, I would like to send you off to sixth grade with the same five pieces of advice. Number one, just like a pencil, you have made your mark here at KES. You've made very positive marks here at KES. And as you move on to your next school, you will have the opportunity to make fresh new marks. Continue creating the kinds of impressions that have made us all so proud. Two, just like a pencil, you are not perfect. Nobody is. Everyone makes mistakes. You too have the ability to make corrections. Continue to be your best, say you're sorry, right or wrong, and take responsibility for your actions. What matters most is not the mistake itself, but how you handle it. And just like a pencil, it's not what's on the outside that matters. It's what you are on the inside that really matters. Your care and kindness, your bright ideas, the ways in which you choose to give a helping hand, and your special talents and interests will always be the most important part of you. And just like a pencil, you too will have experiences in your lives when you feel a little worn down and need a good sharpening. Maybe it's not being selected for a team or not doing as well as you expected on an assessment, or maybe a friend disappoints you. This sharpening may be painful in the moment, and you may not realize it at the time, but it's these challenges in life that help you to become stronger and better prepared for the next dull or difficult moment. And finally, just like a pencil, you too need a guiding hand in order to experience success. Allow your family and your teachers and your friends to continue guiding you in their loving and caring hands. I hope you live by this advice and become the greatest and mightiest you, and that you leave KES with a purpose in your heart. We are all so proud of what you have accomplished at KES. Congratulations, we will miss you here. I also want to congratulate families who are graduating KES. If your fifth grader is your youngest and last KES student, and you are also graduating KES, could you please stand so we can give you a round of applause? So that ends our ceremony today for this wonderful and special group of fifth graders. Let's give them one more round of applause. I'd like to thank Mr. Gelfer for everything he's done to make today's celebration so wonderful. I'd like to thank the fifth grade team of teachers. You've done a fantastic job this year. I do want to shout out to Tara Duffy and Maria Horton in the main office. And of course, George Cook and his custodial crew sets the stage. And the fourth grade parents have put together a wonderful reception for all of you to enjoy. And before we make our way across the hall to the cafeteria to enjoy that, just a couple of very quick announcements. One is, When you dismissed this afternoon, please make sure you sign out. There's a sign out table. We know from the dismissal forms who plans to leave with you after the reception, and those who are staying will go back to the classroom. There's no use of the playground until after school hours, until after the buses pull away at 12:15. And lastly, and this is more on an up note, our art program has a cherished tradition where each student creates one self-portrait each year. And Mrs. Eckler, our art teacher, keeps them safe in the archives, and the collection grows each year as the students grow themselves. So today, fifth grade artists will finally take home their long-anticipated cumulative collection of self-portraits. As you look through, you'll notice that this collection not only shows the growth in their skill, but also serves as a personal reflection of each year that they've spent here at KES. So upon leaving today, please make sure that you find your child's, you find your own self-portrait portfolio. They're in the hallways here between the gym and the cafeteria, and it is a wonderful memento to cherish for years to come. So I hope you enjoy that. I just want to thank everybody. Thank you for sharing these beautiful children with us, and thank you for being part of this wonderful and loving and caring and nurturing school community. And I wish you all the very best. I wish you a wonderful summer, and the best is yet to come. Thanks, everyone. KES.